But the foods, generally considered healthy, can present hidden dangers. Here are the worst foods for your health and your kidneys you wouldn't suspect. Hello and welcome. This is Catherine from 00 Kidney. Subscribe now and stay always updated. If you care about your health, you may already know that there are a lot of different ways to damage it without even noticing. I'm talking about genetically modified organism foods. You know what is the worst part about GMO foods? That nobody really knows they're eating them. And probably you're eating them too, on a daily basis. Why? In the US, only 26% of the population believe that they ever came in contact with GMOs, according to a recent study. But if we go shopping for groceries, almost anything we're going to buy contains GMOs. This is what the Grocery Manufacturers Association states. According to their estimates, 70 to 80% of all the food we eat in the US contains GMOs. This is shocking. Okay, not so shocking if you think about how good-looking fruits and vegetables on the shelves are compared to those you grow in your garden. And while in Europe GMOs are regulated and labeled, in the US it is really hard to distinguish between organic and modified fruits and vegetables. Yes, GMO foods have been around for decades, but almost nobody knows enough about them. And for decades, this was even true for the food industry. They are basically experimenting on an unaware population. Nowadays, there is a lot more info about GMOs, and not everything is bad. Still, there are a lot of concerns, especially for people suffering from kidney disease and other chronic diseases. For example, the process of altering the genomes in the plant's DNA can increase the presence of toxins, allergens, and anti-nutrients. GMO soybeans have been observed with sky-high levels of soy allergens, up to 7 times more than organic soybeans. Another concern regards the increasing GMO contamination of organic crops. This is especially relevant for corn cultivation, since it is cross-pollinated, meaning that the pollen is transferred by wind or insects. Preventing the stronger GMO pollen from contaminating organic crops seems almost impossible. And even when everything else goes fine, one of the declared main goals of the GMO industry is to make plants more resistant to herbicides and pesticides, so they can use more of those in the crops. And guess what? Most herbicides and pesticides are classified as carcinogenic, probably carcinogenic or tumor promoters by the World Health Organization. And still, genetically modified organisms have some advantages. They are cheaper to farm and, in some cases, have better nutritional value. They also look better on the shelves. I know all this information can look confusing and scary, especially when you realize that all the healthy food you're eating is genetically modified. My personal opinion? Until we get more significant tests and studies on the safety of GMOs, I'll just keep buying certified organic foods. This is all for today. If you like this video, please like and subscribe. Feel free to ask any question in comment section or in our blog, newhopeforkidneypatients.com. Thank you for watching.